Thank you. Welcome. Our opening song, of course, Amazing Grace by Leanne Rimes, reminds us that forgiveness and redemption is available to everyone. We gather here today as family and friends to support each other with our love and understanding as we mourn the loss of Danny Delisle. We're also joined by those on our live stream who I know send their good thoughts and prayers to you in this time of need. There are no words to describe what you're feeling at this time, and no comfort that can be given to take away the pain of losing a loved one. Each of our pain is different, so we must allow each other to grieve in our own way. During this time of reflection, don't be afraid to laugh, and don't be afraid to cry. This is a safe place for all of us to grieve and honor Danny's memory. As we pause to think of Danny and center our thoughts and prayers on Danny, let us offer up our prayers to them. Let us pray. May the Lord bless you. May he pour out his love and heal your hearts of any sadness or hurt associated with Danny's death. May the Lord fill your hearts with peace, and may he help guide you through the grieving process. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. As we prepare to honor Danny with our time and our attention, I would like to mention something that Gabby, mentioned to me, which I think really talks about forgiveness and acceptance and relates to that. Apparently, when Danny was in the hospital and was talking to their friend Linda, they were talking about heaven. And Danny told Linda, "Not me. They won't let me in there." So why did Danny feel this? What led to Danny feeling they were not worthy enough to be accepted into heaven? We can look at lots of examples in the Bible, but I think let's look at Luke 6:37 and let it be our guide in this matter. As it states, "Do not judge, and you will not be judged. Do not condemn, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven." Also in the same Luke 6, verse 31 says, "Do unto others as you would have them do to you." Now, most of us know this is the golden rule, so let us live by that rule and those words and treat others the way we want to be treated. And applying that rule to everyone that we cross paths with. As we do this, we are accepting of others, and we let the Lord God take care of judgments. So how do we judge? Let us look back on Danny's life, and let us not judge the life, but celebrate it. Let us pause to honor a life that meant the world to us, Danny's life. Now, Gabby was good enough to put together a eulogy to honor Danny, which I'd like to share for her. Danny was born to Lloyd Edward and Ardell Delisle. Their family moved quite a bit in the early years, legal, the Grove Motel, the trailer park, Swan Hills on 23rd Ave, before they landed in Tofield. Danny was the last child of a large family. As Danny was the beloved oops of her parents, and being the last child, Danny was spoiled by everyone. Danny looked up to their father, and when their father passed, when Danny was at the young age of 14, they began to look up to their older brothers, Arden and Lynn. In the history of photographs that you'll see later, it's evident that they were emulating their father and brothers. Being the youngest of six, Danny's bad behavior was often enabled instead of being deterred. Danny always presumed that one of their older siblings would get them out of trouble and look after them. Danny loved their family. They adored their mom and dad, and they loved their nephews and nieces. They used to take part take them to the places, photograph them playing in the park or dressing them up in Western costumes. When they weren't hanging out with their nephews and nieces, they were playing with dogs. They loved dogs, possibly their favorite thing in the world, followed by country music and cigarettes. Danny had a passion for photography and photographed many of their friends' events, like weddings, baby showers, and stagettes. Danny truly fell in love twice in their lifetime. The first, a puppy love, was during their coming of age as a young teenager to another youth named Candace. They once told Dustin, their nephew, that Candace was their first girlfriend. Later in life, they joined union with a longtime friend turned partner, Heather Campbell. They got married and they were together for over 20 years. They loved each other dearly and remained friends even after they parted ways. And Gabby was really good enough to reach out to Heather, and Heather supplied some other words, which I'd like to interrupt your words for a few minutes and share the many happy memories that Heather wrote down in a tribute. And it goes like this. Over many years, Danny and I enjoyed a lot of good memories. Danny was part of the People's Church in Edmonton for many years and had many friends there in the 1980s and 1990s. That was actually how we first became friends. We met in 1984 and became good friends. I invited Danny to come and visit with my family on the farm back in Ontario. And I think that was her first flight on a jet plane. It wasn't our first trip to Ontario. It wasn't on the first trip to Ontario, but it may have been on one of the successive trips there. Danny had been complaining how boring was the four-hour flight to Ottawa. Back in those days, there was no movies or on the longer flights, but we did get meals and snacks. On the way back home to Alberta that time, we were only up in the air a few minutes when we heard a distinct noise. And I thought it was just the noise of the wheels going back up into the wings. But a couple minutes later, the pilot came back on and announced that we had lost an engine and we had to drop some fuel and land back in Montreal to get a new plane. Needless to say, we were a couple hours late getting home, but happy just to land safely home again. Never again did we ever want anything other than a boring flight every time that we flew. Danny always had lots of ideas that she figured that we should do. When our living arrangements where we were renting with friends were changing, she got the brilliant idea that we should buy a condo together in Millwoods. After a while, she finally convinced me that maybe we should get a dog. We could have written a book about the first 6 months of training that dog would end up becoming and dealing with. And of course, that dog, Buddy, became Danny's best friend. We enjoyed that place for about 8 years. During that time, we became partners, and after my parents had passed, we were able to upscale and build a beautiful home, a beautiful new home, just east of Millwoods. By now, we had another lovely Shih Tzu dog named PJ, and a few months after Buddy passed, we decided that PJ was lonely, and Little Miss Peanut, a poodle mixed with a Pomeranian, came into our lives. By that time, we had learned a little more about training dogs and enjoyed them from the onset. Every family day, weekend, around Danny's birthday, we would go on a little trip or plan one. We enjoyed a lovely family day in Victoria by the bay, from where we all could see and watch the seaplanes as they flew in and out. We had come to Victoria long after sunset, and the next morning when we woke up, it felt like one of those seaplanes was actually going to land right through our front window into the living room. Later that weekend, it was towards the end of the Olympics, we watched the Canada team win the gold medal in hockey with Wayne Gretzky and company. Another family day weekend in Vancouver, we so enjoyed all the spring flowers in February. It was in 2005, when gay marriage had become legal in Saskatchewan. We went off to Regina, had a little ceremony where my cousins were in attendance, and a couple we knew from St. Albert were there, Donna and Rhea, and they became our witnesses. When we got back on the Victoria Day weekend, we had a big celebration with family and friends. After a few years, our new home and getting a place looking like it was a show home, we decided to move over to the Capilano area. A good friend at the time, Mary Lou, worked with us and completely got our dated older home totally renovated. While we were together, we had a motor home, and one June, I'd taken a whole month of June off work so we could take a trip down to Ontario for my niece's wedding, and then go off to Quebec City, PEI, New Brunswick, Nova Scotia, and back home again. Danny's mom and Wendy's joined us for a couple of weeks. They were able to spend a few extra days with Lyndon and Heather when we finally got to Ontario. They joined us for the journey, of course, to Quebec City and a few days in PEI before it was time for them to go back home. And Danny and I really enjoyed Cape Breton, visiting a little cafe in Mabou, which the Rankins owned, and at least one or two of them would be playing almost every night of the week. Then there were the Callies that we enjoyed a couple more places in the Maritimes. For work, Danny had been a cleaning lady for a few years. Then she was able to acquire work as a PSW for a few years. This work she loved. She loved being able to take care of senior folks and spend time with them. For a couple of years, she worked privately with a client named Donnie, where she would stay overnight, plan meals, and care for all of her needs. Donnie loved our dogs and was able to have them on her bed, even the night we had the privilege of being with Donnie when she passed away. This was one of Danny's most fulfilling work experiences. After I retired in 2007, we moved to Medicine Hat, where I worked part-time. Early that first summer, Peanut had puppies for the second time. She was a spoiled little diva dog, and it was no surprise at how good of a mom she was. As soon as her puppies arrived, she was on duty 24/7 with them. We just had to make sure that she herself, as a mama, was properly fed and cared for. We kept Cashew, a rough and tumble, agile Yorkie Pompoo mix, and she is now 16, and though just now starting to show her age, she's alive and she's well. In 2008, we had an incredible trip to Europe with our friends Anne and Bruce. We spent a week in Germany, Paris, and London, then caught a cruise from the White Cliffs of Dover to Copenhagen, Denmark, a little town in East Germany, a stop in Finland, a two-day stop in St. Petersburg, the Ukraine, a delightful stop in Estonia, and Amsterdam in Holland. After the last day of the cruise, we were able to tour Windsor Castle, even caught the changing of the guards there, and witnessed as flights out of Heathrow Airport flew over the castle. When we moved to Medicine Hat, we would always try to make it to see Danny's mum frequently. Danny had been very close with her mum, and she had a close bond. Our holidays and vacations were favorite times together. Sometimes her health wasn't the best, but we would make the best of it. Danny enjoyed to have fun, and it was fun spending all those times with her. We spent many a tent camping days together, had a trip to Vegas, a wonderful week in Puerto Vallarta, Mexico, a trip to Mazatlan, and three Caribbean cruises together. On the home front, we know that Danny loved to collect things. At one point, she had a huge pin collection from all of the places to where she had traveled. I think Will Adair ended up with a chunk of that collection. She also collected shot glasses from the many places where we traveled. And she loved to bake. and apparently she learned a few tricks from her own mom. For a time in the garage of the Capilano home, she had a workshop set up for woodworking hobby. This workshop moved with us when we moved to Medicine Hat, and in Medicine Hat, she learned the art of pen crafting. Many of her friends and family received either a beautifully crafted wood or acrylic pen from her. And of course, who could forget her big collection of Coca-Cola items. In two of her homes, she had the entire totally themed Coca-Cola rec room, our Capilano home in Edmonton and our first home in Medicine Hat. So many memories. Now, Heather shared these memories and said in the email that there is so much more she could mention. But she also added these last few thoughts. Danny was a very generous person and loved giving gifts. She would try to find just the perfect gift for people. Danny would put her whole heart and soul into all of her pursuits, and often her precious heart would end up broken. But she would give it her best effort. Thank you to Heather for sharing those words. And regarding Heather's last observations, they're also mirrored in words that were penned by Gabby, and her eulogy continues as such. Danny had a quirky sense of humor, and like their brothers, was a generous being. But Danny was also a very trusting person, and sometimes people took advantage of that. And often that meant trying to get their older brothers or sisters to help them out of their mess that their friends put them in. But sometimes that goes with the territory of kindness. We want to believe that human beings are inherently good people, and it's not always the case. And Danny struggled with that. Luckily, in spite of all the medical issues she faced, or because of them, she ended up in the care facility where they found friends and a support system to live their lives in their truest self. It was during these past years, after losing their big brother Arden, that they began the transition. It was odd for Dustin that when he went to the hospital, he'd have to refer to Danny as a he, him, and a male. He'd always grown up with his aunt being a she or a he and female. But looking back on the history of pictures, we noticed that Danny was always most comfortable looking like a boy. And there was the occasional dresses, but 80% of the pictures from childhood to recent have Danny in very masculine attire, which is why, out of both respect for the family that have known her as her and the current friends and support group that have known Danny as him, we've landed on them, with a beautiful Indigenous sentiment of a two-spirited person walking this earth. Thank you so much for sharing that, Gabby. Gabby also mentioned Danny's love of dogs, which is evident in Heather's tribute. Gabby talked about the huge collection of Coca-Cola items, and even though I know you've tried to trim the collection down, it is still apparently huge. Yes, and of course, there's Danny's collection of cookbooks and personal cookbooks that Danny was actually writing. Now, before sharing the slideshow, I'd like to leave you with one more story that Gabby shared with me. And I think it really brings home the point of looking for the signs in the universe that leaves us wanting and learning and wondering. After Danny's passing, Gabby started to notify and call Danny's loved ones to let them know what had happened. When Gabby and Dustin got to the hotel, they turned the television on, switched it on for just a little distraction, and the movie Color Purple was on, with gospel music playing. Dustin was trying to say something, but Gabby started to shush Dustin, saying, "The cosmos is trying to tell us something." This is when they both realized that the song the character Shug Avery was singing is entitled, "God is Trying to Tell You Something." In the same scene, Shug is being followed by a large group of people. And she says out loud as she walks through the church doors to her dad, who is the pastor, "See, Daddy, sinners have souls too." As a human race, we know that we're all sinners and fall short of the glory of God. But by the grace of Christ Jesus, we can find redemption. It is for him to judge. And because of this, I have faith that Danny will be welcomed on the other side and will be reunited with all the loved ones that have gone before them. As Heather said in her email, there is so much more to tell about Danny. So I encourage you to share your stories with each other afterwards. For now, let us wrap together the verbal memories that we've listened to with some visual ones that the family has selected. Accompanying these images will be three country songs, of course, country songs, that have wonderful themes within them, and hopefully they remind you of Danny. So as we view these images, we'll listen to If We Never Meet Again by Johnny Cash, The Gambler by Kenny Rogers, and How Beautiful Heaven Must Be by George Jones. And thanks to Dustin for finally taking Danny on a ride in your Mercedes SLX 230 convertible.
Soon we'll come to the end of life's journey, and perhaps we'll never meet anymore, till we gather in heaven's bright city, far away on that beautiful shore. If we never meet again this side of heaven, as we struggle through this world and its strife, there's another meeting place somewhere in heaven, by the side of the river of life, where the roses bloom forever, and where separation comes no more. If we never meet again this side of heaven, I will meet you on that beautiful shore. Oh, they say we shall meet by the river, where no storm clouds ever darken the sky, and they say we'll be happy in heaven, in that wonderful sweet by and by. If we never meet again this side of heaven, as we struggle through this world and its strife, there's another meeting place somewhere in heaven, by the side of the river of life, where the roses bloom forever, and where separation comes no more. If we never meet again this side of heaven, I will meet you on that beautiful shore.
Summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, I met up with a gambler. We were both too tired to sleep, so we took turns of staring out the window at the darkness, till boredom overtook us and he began to speak. He said, "Son, I've made a life out of reading people's faces, knowing what the cards were by the way they held their eyes. So if you don't mind my saying, I can see you're out of aces. For a taste of your whiskey, give you some advice. So I handed him my bottle, and he drank down my last swallow. Then he bummed a cigarette and asked me for a light. And the night got deathly quiet, and his face lost all expression. Said, if you're gonna play the game, boy, you gotta learn to play it right. You got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. Every gambler knows that the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep. 'Cause every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser, and the best that you can hope for is to die in your sleep. And when he finished speaking, he turned back toward the window, crushed out a cigarette, faded off to sleep. And somewhere in the darkness, the gambler, he broke even. But in his final words, I found an ace that I could keep. You got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. Be time enough to count when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold 'em,
when to hold 'em,
know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough to count when the deal is done.
Of a place that's called heaven. It's made for the pure and the free. These truths in God's word he hath given. How beautiful heaven must be. How beautiful heaven must be. Sweet home of the happy and free. Fair haven of rest for the weary. How beautiful heaven must be. In heaven no drooping nor pining, no wishing for elsewhere to be. God's light is forever there shining. How beautiful heaven must be. How beautiful heaven must be. Sweet home of the happy and free. Fair haven of rest for the weary. How beautiful heaven must be. The angels so sweetly are singing, up there by the beautiful sea. Sweet chords from their gold harps are ringing. How beautiful heaven must be. How beautiful heaven must be. Sweet home of the happy and free. Fair haven of rest for the weary. How beautiful heaven must be. How beautiful heaven must be.
Beautiful image. Danny Delisle will be missed, but they will never truly be gone if they're remembered in your hearts and minds. So talk about Danny, think of him, and remember those times that they touched your heart in some way. As I said, stories about Danny will be appreciated, so please share these with each other afterwards in the fellowship gathering or in the days or weeks to come. The family would like to thank you for attending this celebration of Danny's life, either in person or online. Following this service, you are invited to join with family and friends to continue to celebrate Danny's life with a time of fellowship and nourishment. As we continue to honor and remember Danny Delisle, let us offer up our final prayers for them. God our Father, because of your great mercy, we are not saying goodbye, but until we meet again. Our dear one has passed from this life, but is not gone forever. We commend Danny's spirit to you. Sustain their soul and enfold them in your love until we meet at Jesus' feet. Until then, may your arms encircle this family and friends. Hide them under your wings in this season of sadness and loss, and be their guide through the uncertainties, and their faithful friend in a time of loneliness. We pray, Amen. As we exit from here, please say your own goodbyes and prayers for Danny and their family as we listen to Hallelujah by Pentatonix.
David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty. Kitchen chair, she broke your throne and she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the hallelujah.
not a cry that you hear at night. It's not so much.